I'll continue in English. Please, for everybody who is interested in also to develop a business in mining and geology in Serbia, the GRAS is right address for you. I mean, because of all the membership connections and all benefits that you can have, as well also the KENSI. And now Mirjana, floor is yours. Mirjana will give you much more details about what KENSI is doing and about the benefits of being a member of KENSI. Please, Mirjana, floor is yours.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Jagoda, and the organizers for this 10th Jubilee International Conference. Congratulations. I know it's been a lot of effort put in running such a conference for many years. I think we're all sad today that we're doing this online and we miss, you know, the usual way we've been going about, because this was a very important time of the year, each year when we would get to see our companies, network, discuss different topics. Well, but life must go on, Corona or not, we're strong and we will survive. I would like to welcome you all from KENSI, Canadian Serbian Business Association, whose managing director I'm myself, for you who didn't know about it. We are full service, member-driven business association, focused on creating and developing economic relations between Canada and Serbia. Our mission is basically to promote trade and economic development between Canada and Serbia and vice versa. Our vision is to create stronger bilateral relations for the prosperity of KENSI members. And at the moment, we have 10 founding members and close to 60 valuable KENSI members. Our mining and exploration industry group is quite large. We do have pretty much all the companies that have invested and been working in Serbia so far. Not only Canadians, we also have UK companies, Australian, Finland, and as well, I would like to say some of them are investors and some of them are service companies. We are an organization that started 6 years ago and still growing. Something that I would like to share with you quickly what have been we done in the past. And what is our role when it comes to this exploration and mining industry group? It's basically in March 2015, KENSI was a co-organizer with the Embassy of Canada here in Belgrade, their trade section, and Serbian Chamber of Commerce and Industry of Serbia. We organized the workshop under the name Enabling Mining Legislation, when we were able to bring a leading world and Canadian expert, Mr. Michael Doggett, who held a presentation during the workshop called Finding the Balance, Government Policy and Attracting Foreign Investment in the Mining Sector. This was our contribution in supporting the new mining law that came in power that year. Something also that for you who don't know, BDAC, Prospector Developer Association of Canada, one of the biggest conferences this year, next year will be 84th time in a row. One of our founding members, Reservoir Minerals, received a Tyre Lindsay Award for the best international discovery, credited with basically for the copper gold deposit in the heart of Serbia, Bor's mining camp. Basically, this puts, in a way, Serbia on the spot globally. Later on, year 2016, again, in cooperation with the Canadian Embassy, Dr. Bill Mercer, leading a person, a Canadian geologist and expert in health and safety and exploration and mining, was a guest speaker at this mining conference. And something that we're very proud for all our members from different industry groups, different industries, Corporate social responsibility is something that they practice and they behave. And the Chamber of Commerce and Industry of Serbia each year, starting in 2007, has been giving national award for social responsible companies. And just one example, in 2017, for example, we had several of our members receiving the award: Delta Holding, Apatinska Brewery, Molson Coors, Rudnik. So it is just the way we do business here in Serbia. Next, what I would like to share with you is that for the last 2 years, thankfully to our valuable members from the mining and geological industry group, KANSI was able to organize and sponsor Serbian ministerial delegation to Prospector Developer Association of Canada conference in Toronto, Canada. And we were very lucky that we were there at the beginning of March, just as pandemic started, and fulfilled all the, you know, aims and meetings and everything we planned. And we returned all healthy. Something that I want to share with you is that basically the delegation was headed with the Serbian Minister of Mining and Energy at the time, and also State Secretary and Assistant Minister at the time. And also we had one of the news reporters that was directly reporting from Toronto. This visit to this biggest global mining event is very important, and it has this aim of promoting Serbia as a good place for investment, as well as raising level of economic relations between our two countries, and putting Serbian potential in geological discoveries and mining on the world map. The minister had a chance to meet the Canadian minister of natural resources, Honorable Simon O'Regan, at the opening ceremony. And also minister was able to have a presentation during the Tatian Belt, Western Tatian Belt session, which is for the fourth time in a row organized by the KANSI founding member Munduro Capital during PDAC. This is basically an opportunity for company representatives to present their special project in the Western Tatian Belt. And like Tio said earlier, practically Serbia and Bulgaria, outlining all the benefits and challenges in the further progress of their projects, while the government representatives offered regional insight. The conclusion of session was that the western part of Tatian Belt, although abundant in mineral deposits, remains unexplored region with good infrastructure, skilled local workforce, low-cost service exploration, good government infrastructure and mining laws. So an invitation for other interested companies to come to this part of the world and do their business. Also, we're proud that for you who maybe didn't have a chance to hear about this during PDAC, on the second day, there's an International Mines Ministers Summit, and 26 ministers from all over the world are invited. It's a closed type of the summit within PDAC. And for the second time in the row, Serbian minister was invited, which is to us a great honor. And beside from this region, Turkish minister, Serbia was the only other country invited. Also, I would like to say that this time Serbia did really raise the spotlight. We were invited also by the Mining Journal to give an interview about potentials and things in Serbia, the way business is done in Serbia. As well, some of other things that we do in collaboration with Canadian Embassy. Before going to PDAC in January 2020, we were organizing a trilateral dialogue on corporate social responsible practices, Canadian experience, and that went really well. Pretty much all the companies that are practicing in Serbia were able to share the practices that they offer in Serbia. These are all our valuable members, and throughout this unusual and difficult year, we have been following our members, and they have been putting more effort than ever to continue with their field work and prospects and expanding. For example, our valuable founding member, Mundoro Capital, has announced that it has entered into binding memorandum of understanding with Valley Canada Limited and is pleased to expand its relations by signing the option of two Mundoro's projects in Timok, Serbia. Then, for example, for another interesting fact, Dundee Precious Metals, as well founding member of CAMC, is recognized as a top TSX performer for 2020 in recognition of its strong three-year share price performance. Darin Ventures, Balkan Gold, completed field exploration work in Kiskanya Bor deposit, and request has been submitted for the retention of the right to exploration space to the competent Ministry of Mining and Energy. The next steps are towards the preparation of study on resources and reservoirs. Met Gold Resource Corporation announced positive metallurgic results for Barrier prospects. So on and so forth, everybody keeps working and it's very busy still. Like T also said, you know, it's harder, it's taking longer, but the industry is working and putting a great effort. And something else to add, that we've been very active each year in Toronto. We've organized the Canadian CANC business forums, events, cocktails, where we invite all sorts of different businesses from different industries. This year, it was a big networking event. We were very glad that we had a representative from Serbian government and as well a government of Canada, Global Affairs Canada. Miss Jutta Work was present. She made a short remarks to esteemed guests about our relations. And as always, each one of us can be leader for a change. I believe all the people, all the speakers, participants are one of the leaders. Something that CANC proudly presents each year is a leader project, mini MBA program that we do. Something that is organized each May. And each year we get 40 Serbian participants to receive a world-class Canadian educational training, fully supported by CANC and Canadian University in cooperation with Canadian Embassy in Belgrade and Serbian Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Till this day, 160 leader project alumni, very proud, stay tuned. May 2021, there will be another leader project coming. And what the mind of man can conceive and believe, it could be achieved. CANC strongly believes with its members that education helps build values like integrity, excellence, gender equality, values of individuals, and responsibility in the use of resources. And in that respect, we support and invest in the future of Serbian people, therefore building a more responsible nation. We like to set the goals very high. So by 2030, our ambition is to double the economic effects while growing our CANC family. For you who are still not members of CANC, please contact us. Do not hesitate. A lot of opportunities to connect, to build your business, to get trusted advice by our CANC members or us in CANC office. And thank you and keep inspiring others. Please follow us on our website and our LinkedIn. Again, thank you to Ms. Jagoda Dokic and Mr. Tsamokos and TGI organization for doing a wonderful job. Thank you to all of you all over the world joining us today. And I wish you the pleasant rest of the day and let's hear other presentations. Thank you again. And greetings from Belgrade.
Dear Mirjana, thank you very much for this lovely presentation. It's very, very inspiring to see what the benefits also, of course, and grass and can see as well provides. And that is why we love to cooperate with both of these associations for many years. And please feel free to make a contact with them. I'm especially saying for the new companies who for the first time are here as attendees at the mining conference. So I will put all these presentation from all these speakers after the conference on our website. And then you will feel free to see them again, of course, to use the contacts in them for whoever you need, which company or association you need. And now, before we continue with the program and start with the next panel, let's see the second part of our commercials with the spots for our sponsors. So please stay for a couple of more minutes and then we will continue with the next panel. Thank you.